So you guys see the simple structure I took and then just created a table using HTML. So this is something which we discussed yesterday. And as far as coding is concerned, even if the table looks simple to weave, there was a bit of coding involved, and I'll just show you that. So in the edit class. Cool. So this is what we did yesterday. So whatever was there inside the style tag refers to the CSS code. We needed a bit of CSS in order to display the table with borders and everything. That's why you see some CSS properties here. We'll discuss this when we start CSS. And meanwhile, table is something which we created using the table tag, which starts at this particular line and it is ending here at last. In order to create a row of the table, you need to use tr, and data is added using th and td tags, where th refers to the header. Whenever you want to add a table with a header, you will use th tag, and when you want to add the data, you will use td tag. And I'll show you the difference between the, see here, all these display formats which are displaying contents which are displaying in bold are actually added using th tags. And the subjects what I have added here are actually added using the td tags. Okay, so this is what we discussed yesterday. Anyways, so I'll continue with we will see how to add an image. For that, I'll create a separate file. In the end, we'll have one session wherein we will combine everything. See, as in one of our sessions, we discussed about these things, which talks about header tags, the ordered list, everything. At last, when we are completely done, we will put everything into one single page and just take a look at that. Because if now I continue to keep on adding contents, it will be very confusing for you guys to understand, as well as me to keep track of what has been covered and what else is left out. Because HTML is a larger library which has a lot of things involved. So I'll be teaching you some of the important concepts of HTML that are used on a frequent basis. Okay. Anyway, so all these things, as I said, will be combined later on into one single page. We don't have anything as of now to do here. So I'll just create a HTML file, which I already have. Now I'll just start this. I always, love using the header tags because it gives you the clarity about what exactly is there in that particular web page. Always use header tags to ensure you give some significance about the content that you're going to add. Okay, so I'll just have this as image insertion in the back page. I'll save this. I'll name it as image.html. Okay, I'll save this. It will ask me to add the extension automatically. Click on yes, it will add the extension. You can see the extension as .html here, image.html. And I'll just open this page now in the browser. Okay, so I have the header which I just inserted using the h1 tag inside the body tag. So here's the body tag, and inside which I have just added the header. Now, in order to add an image in HTML, we make use of a tag called as img tag. Okay, img. And it's not like I've been repeatedly talking about one thing, that is most of the tags do not require, or most of the tags are not required to be closed. So this tag will anyhow work even if you don't close it. So I've just added this tag. We'll see what the output will be. Will be nothing. Then we have it here, and I've just added a tag called image tag. Now I need an image. What I'll do, we'll make this session a bit exciting. Okay, so I want this image to be added in my web page, the page which I'm currently working on. So what I have to do is, first thing is I have to copy the name of the image. So go to the properties, or you can actually click on the rename stuff and copy the image name with the extension. Okay, so I'll go to the file which I have created for the purpose of having image. Now inside this, see, img is a tag that will be responsible for displaying the particular image on the web page. But then again, img alone will not be displaying the image on its own. You need to use an additional attribute here called as src. What does src stand for? So src is nothing but the source. Now what I'm trying to tell this image tag is, I'll give you the source in which I'll be passing the image name, which is there in my system. The image is saved in my system, or it may not be there in my system, it may be in other server, but then again we'll talk about that later. Now for now, I have the image in my system. I'll give you the source. I'll give you the image name by passing the image name .jpg. Look for this in the system and just display it. Now what it does, I'll go here. Okay. And I'll refresh the page, so it will not display the image. Okay, you see, there is an icon which is indicating something, which is stating that the image is a not valid one. Now I have this file saved in a different directory. Okay, so see, the directory is G drive, and inside which I have a folder called HTML sessions. Inside that I have image.html file. So this is the file that I'm creating, but the image actually is in a different directory. Okay, so p something, like whatever it is. So it's in a different directory, and that's in downloads. So both are different. So now what I can do is, there are two options for it. Okay, so first option is, I'll just copy this image and I'll paste it inside that folder where I have the file. Okay, so now it is saved. Now I'll refresh the page. Okay, there you go. So here's the image. So image is clearly visible in the web page. So the other way, okay, the other way is, let's say I now talking about this one, the image being added in this particular folder. See, there are two paths of a file, in whichever way you want to give the source. Obviously, there will be file paths wherein you will have the name of the file. Okay, when you just have the name of the file or image. Okay, so where you just have the file, or sorry, image name, and it is in a different folder. Now I'll delete this for now. I have deleted it. It no longer exists in my current directory. See, this is my working directory. This is my workspace. Okay, G drive HTML sessions is where I am saving all my HTML files. So I call this as my workspace. But downloads, if I go to downloads, this is not my workspace, and I do have that image here, right? Okay, so in that case, first way is, you can either move this image to the workspace where you have the HTML file created. Second way is, if you don't want to do that, what you can do is, you can go to the properties, go to the security section, copy the full path. This is called as absolute path of the image. Okay, exact path. Okay, absolute path. There are two types of paths. One is relative path, which refers to the file name alone without the complete path, and absolute path is something that will refer to the complete path of the image. Now I'll go back to the file. I'll just replace the file name with its complete path. I'll save it. Now let me confirm that we don't have the file here. Okay, you can see we don't have any file which we are using in our HTML file. So I'll go back to the document. Where is it? Okay, the other tab, right? Okay, so here it is. Okay, I'll reload this page. You see there is no change. Okay, so one second, I want to show you the change. Reload, you have a broken image icon which states that something is wrong and the image is not being rendered in the web page. Then now I go back, I see what is wrong. The file name is there, but it is in a different directory, different workspace than what I'm using. Okay, so in that case you have two options. Either you move the image to the current workspace, that is this one, or you copy the entire path of the image, so which I will be doing now. Control Y, save, go back, reload. So you still have the image now. So this is, something which you have to really consider to your notice while using the image tag. While using the source attribute, you have to ensure that the image is in the same directory if you are passing the image name alone. If the image is saved in a different location than what you have your HTML file saved, in that case you have to give the entire path or complete path of the image. So only then it will work. Now I'll maximize this. I want to show you something here. Now see, the image is right. Oh, sorry, it's on the left side of the file. So alignments and all, we will talk about alignments. But before that, I can control the height and width also of this image. And one more important thing what I wanted to discuss here is, I'll do Control Z. I'll reload this. I just have a broken image. Okay. Now this may happen, in a lot of cases where you may actually give the correct path, but despite that, in your projects generally, when you will be using Eclipse, when your server will be having some images, and if a developer is making a spelling mistake also, in that case the image will broke. I mean, the icon will be in a broken state. Then in this case, what you can do is you can actually give a message to the user, okay, saying that what exactly is wrong. I want to pass some image after this. Okay, but I just want don't want to have this icon, icon all alone. So instead of that, what I'll do, I'll just pass a message when the file path is invalid. So I'll go to the image tag. I have one attribute here which is taking the image name as the value. Now I'll give space. I'll use AALT. This is an attribute. What does AALT stand for? Okay, it's nothing but alternative, or you can call it as alternate attribute. So which actually displays a specific thing when you don't have the expected thing being displayed on the screen. Now I want the image to be displayed. It is not displaying. In that case, I can give a message to this saying that invalid image path or forward slash image did not load. Okay, just an hint using which we can get to know what exactly is wrong. This is like very rarely used. This will just anyway, icon is all alone sufficient, but then again you need to give a message to the user. Okay, so for that purpose we will be using this alternate attribute. So I'll refresh the page. So this message is also right beside the icon: invalid image path, image did not load. Okay, now what I'll do, I will give the absolute path. Now in this case, should this message be displayed? Should this message be displayed? Now I have given the correct path. There is nothing wrong with this, and I'm sure that, you know, the image will render on the web page correctly. With that, since I have added the alt attribute here, so will the value of alt attribute be displayed in the UI? I mean on the web page. Currently, if you look at this, earlier we just had an icon, broken icon, with no text, which we are passing through the alt attribute. Now with that, we are passing correct path of the image. So will the image be rendering with this particular message, or the image alone will be displayed? Okay, so I'll reload the page and I'll expand the browser. I'll maximize the browser. So see here, so the image is displayed in the UI, and you'll not see that text what I have passed. See, the alternate attribute will come into picture when source is invalid. Okay, so that's why we have alternate attribute, which will take care of just passing a message to the user, giving a hint about what exactly is wrong. So in that case, you know, the hint can be, if the page is not loading correctly, you must have noticed, if you are not connected to internet and if there is an image, in that case the image, you will see those broken icons. That is one case. And second thing is, if you make any mistake, like, you know, let me just, so I think that, you know, I have passed the complete path of the image, but actually that's not the case. So see here, we have the broken icon with the indication about why the image has not been rendered in the web page. So this alternate will pass the value on the web page only when source is not able to load the image. Okay, so now I'll go back, reload, done. Okay, so this is how, you know, you'll have the image. There is, like, see, the image has to be already edited, and you have to add the text on your own. So here in the web page, it is not possible, like adding the you know, content, as you said, like this is what you are expecting to be displayed on the image. So that thing, you know, we have to ensure that that has to be taken care of before the image is made ready to the source. Now, what I'm trying to say here is, I have an image. So I cannot use HTML in order to add some text or something else. I should either go to this photo editor or Photoshop or something else, choose a text box, probably, like, you know, we'll see if I can edit this. Edit time create. Okay, so edit. So you just have to, there is no other way, like, you know, adding the kind of text or any other thing on top of the image. I don't want to crop this adjustments. I was just looking for the option called adding text. Okay, so something like this, you know, if not here, you will get a lot of other editors which will give you the option to add the text. Maybe Paint has that option available. So using which, you know, you can add so and so text or text as per the requirement. But then again, that's why I have a header here which gives some significance about the image. Like when I'm maximizing this, this is appearing on the left side of the web page. So if I want something like, you know, like this, and also I'll show you, you can give your own height and width for the image, and if this has to be displayed in the center, how that can be done, I'll show you that. So for that, obviously we need to refer to the CSS. CSS is all about the style. See, the style attribute here, what I'm using is something which will import or make the CSS properties available to the HTML tag. Okay, always, wherever you use style tag, sorry, style attribute in a particular HTML tag or element, this style will ensure that it will load all the CSS, all, not all, whatever you make, whatever you pass, you know, here, it will ensure that it will load those particular CSS properties and make those properties available for the image tag. So I'll just start with the width. I'll give it as 400px. So width and height, you know, or usually it will be in pixels. Then I'll just reload this. So you see there was auto adjustment, like, you know, a width was provided, but then again accordingly it has adjusted the height. That's how HTML works. But then now if I want to provide some height, okay, so I should use semicolon. I've already told you guys, if you use comma it will throw error. I'll give 700px. Okay, now you see the image has been provided with the height as per what you have passed here, as per the value passed by. So this looks, you know, ugly. No one will have this type of configurations or values assigned to the properties. So I'll have 500px instead. Okay, then again I'll just stretch the image by expanding the 500 into 500. So however you want, you can have control over the image. So this is like, you know, 500 into 500. I can confirm that to you guys. You can refer to the CSS box model. So this is nothing but the CSS box model, wherein you can check the height and width, where first part of this content 500, whatever you see here, the first one refers to the width. Okay, and I'll pass, you know, more width here. Okay, 700px. See here, as soon as I gave 700, this particular value was updated. So this is the width and this is the height. Now if you do some changes in the dev tools, it will be here and those appear to be temporary changes. I mean to say, don't think that your file will get updated. It will never update. See here, here it is still 500px, but then in the dev tools of the web page I've given 700px. And but now if I close this, it will continue to be 700, but then if I reload, it will consume the values from the file again. It will not refer to the DevTools. So DevTools is something like, you know, to do like trial and error stuff. Okay, so you need, I want to know, like, as per my requirement, what can be the width that I can pass. So what I'll do here, I'll check like this. See, that is, see, like this, you know, you can check. So DevTools always help in a lot of you know, estimates. If you're trying to provide a specific width, you know, this should be like this, like, you know, here you can combine, you can edit, then this will help here. Now I want 676. Okay, I am sure I am happy with the width here. Then you should keep a note on this number. Copy this number, 676. Okay, you don't need to copy, just make a note of this 676 in your mind. Go to your browser and then change the value to 676. But before I change that, I'll keep it as 500. I will close the dev tools and I'll reload this. See, it is 500 into 500 now, yet again. So whatever, you know, changes you do here, those changes appear to be temporary changes, not the permanent changes. So if you want it to be want the changes to be permanent, you have to come to the file, update the value with whatever you inspected in the dev tools. So now see, this is how it works. Okay, so we have given the height and width for this, our own height and width. Okay, then what I have to do is I have to display the image in the center of the page, center of the web page. So for that, what I'll do, see, firstly, let me display this, header in the center of the image. For that, what I have to do, I have to give some CSS here. Style is equal to, I'll use a property called text align, colon, center. Text align is a property, CSS property, and the value for that can be left, right, none, and center. Okay, so I will just reload this. See, this has come exactly to the center. I don't have to worry. Like, similarly, I can use a property here called, what property I can use? Can I use image align, img, and img dash align, al colon center. If I write something like this, look at it, it will not work. Okay, because we don't have any such property for aligning the image, so-called image dash align. Okay, now we will check with align. Align property exists in CSS, but this will still not work for image. Okay, see, there's no change. Now what I have to do, I have to use my brain, and then, you know, I have to further utilize some of the other properties that are available. So what I'll do here, the intention of this is to move it somewhere like this with the, you know, fixed width and the height. So I'll inspect this. I'll show you guys with adding a property called as margin. Okay, so now see, margin here appears to be the margin outside the border. So whenever you provide any margin, okay, as per the margin, the contents will be aligned in the CSS part. Okay, so what I'll do, I'll just use this property margin, right click, okay, align is gone. Align, see here, you can see despite using align, it is saying unknown property name. Align does exist in HTML, but for this particular tag, align is not working. So it is showing unknown property. So what I'll do, I'll give margin colon. So then again, okay, we will choose values. Okay, so it is giving some default values here. I'll give auto, nothing, no changes. Inherit and initial. So inherit, see, inherit has a little bit of, no change. I'll close the dev tool. See here. Okay. So every property has its own way of displaying. So we will not use any of this. I want no margin to be provided on my end. What I'll do, I'll give 100 px. See here. Now I gave 100 px. I'll close the dev tool. So the image has been provided with the margin. Now if you inspect this again, and if you go to the box model, look at the margin here. Okay, it, so it is converting it into DM. Okay, so something called as DM. I'll confirm you guys about that tomorrow. Like 1 ps is equal to 16 DM, something like that is there. Okay, so if it is a DM or something else, I will have to check that. Okay, so it is seeing 8 ps. Why is this? Right, okay, I got it. Okay, anyways, we'll discuss this when we start the HTML. So everywhere you see, it is pixels only. Sorry for, you know, the incorrect info. So it is pixels only, 8, 8, 8, and 8. You see? See, if you refer to the box model, if I give margin alone, whatever margin I give, it will be divided and it will be given across the content. So here this top 8 refers to the margin top. I can I can specifically give a different value to the margin top. Okay, so all I have to do is I'll go to the style, then after this, okay, now I'll expand this. Yeah, you see here, margin top is also a property, right is also a property, bottom left is also a property. You can use any of this all alone without using margin. So margin is the parent, and the children of a margin are margin top, margin right, margin bottom, margin left. So whatever width I have given, margin I have given, it has been spread, and it is not 8px. I gave 100px, so it should be 25. So why it is 8? I was actually, weaving the wrong box model here. So it is 100 everywhere. Okay. So see here, if I provide 100 for the margin, the value will not be divided. In fact, it will be given same for all the children of that margin top, margin right, margin bottom, margin left. I got confused, looking at this, referring to this box model. Okay, anyways, that happens, no problem. But now this confirms that the margin pass has been made available to all the children of the margin property. So this is one way. But then again, if I go here, this is still not in the center. I have to bring this to the center. What I have to do, I have to keep on giving the margin. So instead of that, if you look at this, there are a few things that we have added, that is width, height and margin. So I'll use some properties, additional properties, in order to and so that automatically the image can be displayed in center. Okay, so here is our image. I want this to be displayed in the center. So in that case, one thing is confirmed here. It is possible with the help of the margin. Now there are two ways of doing it. You give the margin on your own. Now if I give 100px instead of 100px, what I will do, this is not editable. Okay, this is editable. So I will give it as 400. So see, it has come to the bottom and the margin is given everywhere. So this is, incorrect way. So you cannot, I don't want, margin to be on the top of the page between, you'll never see a page having this much of space between the title and the image. So what I can do, I can consider having, I'll just reload the page. I'll reload the page. Now we have the image here. Let's assume the image to be somewhere here like this, okay, with the current height and width, okay, something like this. So what I can do, see, I don't want margin on the top and in the bottom. So all I need is the margin on the left. This is one way. Okay. So I will give margin dash left colon 400px. Let's see where the image appears. See, but still you see this is not exactly in the center. Then you can take help of the dev tools. Go to the ESS model, box model. And you try giving lesser margin. Okay, 380, we'll check with 380. Okay, so 380. You see, when you go for this approach, you will not be so sure. Okay, but then again, it's okay. Like if you can use your dev tools in order to have it aligned to the center, 360. And now it looks like it is in center, but accurately if we look at this, it is not in the center. Okay, so it is okay, in some cases nobody would bother, what is the margin on the left, what is the margin on the right. So in order to have this drawback, in order to have this problem solved, what we can do is I can go here and I can pass a value called as auto. Okay. Now then I'll close this. it will come to the left one. Okay, so auto margin left auto is not sufficient alone. In that case, I would have to consider another property here called margin right. It has to display based on two things, either the top and bottom or the left and right. So I'm taking a margin left and margin right because I want the image to be aligned in the center. So now if I reload this again, it will not display nothing. But then I will add a special property here called as display, and the value for that should be block. I will tell you, like, you know, we are yet to discuss block and inline. There are two things that are categorized in HTML, block and inline. Now as soon as I pass this, you need not to pass it here only. I'll not have it here. You can pass wherever you want. Just ensure that the syntaxes are proper. So you see, it's exactly in the center now. I don't have to worry about, you know, going to the dev tools, inspect, refer to the box model, what is the, you know, margin. Again, you know, I've come to this. But what is the margin here? The exact margin is, now it is showing 337, 337. And top and bottom, you see, there are no values because I'm not given it. Okay, I don't want any space on the top and the bottom. I just want the image to be aligned in the center. This is something, you know, how you can do it. And talking about the properties that we have, see, display is something which will be responsible for displaying either in the block format or inline format. Block and inline, we will take it up for tomorrow because a lot of tags here. If we talk about H1 tag, it is a block level tag, and there is a tag called as span tag, which is a inline tag. So we will discuss about that, you know, in tomorrow. Then you will get to know about how display consumes block as the value and inline as the value. I will give inline here. It goes back to where it was earlier. It goes back to where it was earlier. So this margin left and margin right will work with the value auto when you have the value for display as block. So this is working fine. So just, you know, it's like the combination of properties. Now you may just wonder, okay, what happens? I can, okay, let me just show you this also. I will remove. Margin right and the margin left. Maybe, you know, you guys may assume that display alone, or display block may alone would work. That does not work. Okay, I'll close this. It will go back to where it was initially. So display in the form of block with left margin left and margin right as auto. So this is the combination you have to use in order to align any content which is not aligned with the help of some properties that are already available. Text align is one property, align is one property. Okay, so when these are not working, this is what you have to consider doing. Sorry. So now I'll go back and I'll just refresh this so you see the image in the center. So you can provide the border. I have provided border also. Like this, you know, you can border the margin, you can align the image. So this is how our image is added in the web page. Wherever you want, you can configure, but then again, you should give your own values for margin left and right. The end of this session, when you have the HTML content ready, now see here, I have this table, I have this particular, you know, content that we learned in our earlier session, and then now today we have learned about, you know, what is it, displaying the image. Now with this, we have, you know, we are left out with form creation, how a form is created. You see the fields in the form, like, you know, go to facebook.com. okay. So you see, when I create on I mean, when I click on create new account, you have this, particular fields available where you have first name, surname, mobile number, email address, password, all these fields. Okay, we will see how to have a drop down. See, we have a drop down here. This is called as drop down, and this is the radio button. Okay, which should allow me to select only one value at one time. See, I cannot select two values at one time. So all these things, we will be discussing, and we will also have checkboxes, those things. Then we will have audio, and then we will add video. All that stuff we will be adding, and then when everything is added into one single page and weaved like this, it will be, like you will see, and you'll just you can actually be thinking that, okay, so we have the structure now. We have the structure of the web page. Now we have to go for CSS.